Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Star Agent, Starco Gaming here, back with another Marvel Future Fight video. Guys, if you want more amazing content about Marvel Future Fight, make sure to hit the subscribe button and enable the bell next to it to get notified when we post a new video, go live with the live stream. Don't forget that we stream every single night, 7 p.m. Pacific time, guys. And if you want to play Marvel Future Fight on PC, make sure to check the description down below and click on the link next to play Marvel Future Fight on PC. So guys, today what we're going to talk about, Minerva and Alliance Battle Extreme. It's been requested by a few people to do an updated version of Minerva for Alliance Battle Extreme. So today is female supervillain, so we're going to be covering that. Now, what score should you expect from Minerva? That depends on your build. Personally, the build I'm going to be using here is with CTP of energy. So for me, being between 1.4 and 1.6 million on female villain is usually where I'm standing. Some people have better cards, some people have worse cards. So I'll say, depending on your cards, between 1 million and 2 million should be a average spot you should be standing it in, with depending on your build. Obviously, CTP average is a little bit better on her, but not really necessary, because the difference is maybe a 10% difference. It's not a big difference. It's a very, very, very minimal difference. So there's a much, much, much more important targets to actually put a CTP of rage on them. But if you have extra CTP of rage, yeah, sure, she's going to perform better with the rage than with energy. And the skill priority is pretty much the same. The skill rotation you want to proc on the fourth skill, pretty much, and that is pretty much it. It's a little bit more tricky than that with CTP of rage, but it's close to it. Now, the best team for a female villain is this team. You have Titania lead for the 50% increase of physical attack, and you have Black Cat as a team up. Why Black Cat as a team up? That is a good question, guys. That is a cool question, and that answer is really right there. See, the tier 2 passive from White Black Cat, when she strike, she has 60% chance to decrease all buff effect by 80%, duration by 50%. So pretty much when the beast does is roar and actually get his defense increase buff, and you have Black Cat that jump in, strike, and reduce the defense increase by 80%, pretty much, which will help you increase your score by a lot. So definitely, guys, best character to actually bring as a team up on female villain with Minerva. Now, Minerva, how do you want to build her? Well, if you build her with CTP of rage, obviously you need to cap all cooldown, ignore defense, dodge, and critical rate. Now, if you build her with CTP of energy, we're going to look at what a CTP of energy build looks like. So max cooldown, max ignore defense. You want to max your critical damage as much as possible and attack speed. Then you want to get as much critical rate as possible. If we look at the Yuru we're running with here, fully awake, amplify Yuru, 6 stars Yuru everywhere. You can see it's 2 physical attack per gear. Then we cap skill cooldown in your defense here. I only needed 1 in your defense. Then after that, it's critical damage, then critical rate. It's very, very, very simple with her. Best seasonal set for her is actually Power of Angry Hulk to give her that attack speed she needs for that fourth skill of hers. Really, really important. So here we have Power of Angry Hulk, set bonus, 11 in effect, still missing a few stars, but one day I will get it done. So we get 8.5% all attack, all defense, critical rate. We get 8.1% your defense and 7.7% attack speed and activation rate, 12% chance when attacking, plus 35% increase of all attack for 20 seconds. We're gonna go with a cooldown time of 55 seconds. Custom gear, we have a CTP of energy full maxed out, 43.6% in your dodge, critical damage 31.7, 30% chain of damage, and 200% damage product. This could add a little bit more critical damage, but it's a pretty solid one. Now the uniform, we got the uniform mythical. We only get 3 bonus options, so we don't get to min-max, you know, the stats as much as we want here, because we're lacking a few uniform bonus uniform. But anyway, uniform number one, you have X-Force X-23, which we got attack speed here. Second uniform, Black Widow, Infinity War. Third uniform is Punisher, Marvel, Daredevil. Fourth uniform is Moon Girl, Monster Unleashed. And the last uniform is Thor Ragnarok, and we got physical attack there. So those are the bonus uniform we got here. And this is the build. Now the skill rotation, guys. The skill rotation is very, very, very simple. Pretty much you're gonna pop the fifth skill. You're gonna wait till the fifth skill starts, then you're gonna cancel the fifth skill into the third skill to get your summons and your critical rate, your 10% critical rate you're gonna get there. And you actually get 15% attack speed there, so you don't really need that much attack speed on her. You need 115% attack speed on her, by the way, guys. So you're gonna pop that third skill after you use the fifth skill. Once you cancel the fifth skill, you go third skill, you cancel right away, you get your summons, that's all you cared about. Then you go with the fourth skill, get your proc on the fourth skill, then you're gonna use the first skill if you're not in danger of getting CC or anything like that, or the big meteor to drop on you or stuff like that. Then you're gonna repeat the rotation when the fifth skills come back, and it's that's the rotation, guys. It's very, very simple. Obviously, if the bees decide that it targets you when you're casting that, channeling that fourth skill, well, you're gonna get interrupted. And well, you lose a lot of damage, but that's total RNG. There is nothing you can do about that. What you want to do is just run and run until you get a good run, pretty much. That's the only thing you can actually do. Sometimes you're gonna get a run where you don't get interrupted at all, and then you're gonna get the run after, you're gonna get interrupted like 10 times. It's total RNG there. So what we're gonna do next, guys, we're gonna show how to play her, actually. So, you know, I told you the skill rotation and everything, but I didn't show you how to actually play her. So we're gonna jump in there, we're gonna try to have the best possible run. I don't know, we're recording, we usually, when we record, we get bad RNG, so probably gonna get interrupted a few times, but we're still gonna give it a try and show the rotation live in this video, pretty much. So first we gotta wait for the loading screen. Also, when you pop here, you wanna make sure that when you switch target, you don't switch, you know, you start with Titania, then you switch to Minerva. You don't wanna switch when you have mobs close to you, because sometimes it can trigger the proc. If that happened, your whole run is screwed. You gotta force close and restart, pretty much. So you wanna be pretty careful about that. Here we go. Now we got a good start. 4-3-4. Here we go. 1. Then we wait for the fifth skill to be available again, and we just repeat the process here. You want to have that proc as early as possible on your fourth skill. You don't want to get it when the beast jump, because on a female villain, I think you get snare, if I'm not mistaken. Not fully sure which ability it is, but anyway, it's bad for you, so you don't want that to happen. So far, it's not a bad run. Yeah, it's snare. I can see it on Korat here. So you want to avoid getting snare, obviously. Here, see, my proc happened just a little bit too early. That was a mistake I did. You don't want that to happen. You want to make sure that your proc happened on your fourth skill and not on either fifth skill or third skill. And when the beast jump, you ignore the first skill in your rotation, because if you use the first skill and the beast jump you, well, he gets in there and you are screwed. So you want to be very, very, very careful with that. Here we find the beast is actually stunned. Come back here and see, we got snare in the transition here. That was a really, really, really bad luck. It happens though. Then that's what I'm talking about, RNG, because sometimes it's just a matter of, you know, really one bad sync and you're pretty much screwed here. Here, that was a close to get smack in the face. And the last 30 seconds too, the beast start to doing the jump a lot more often. So you gotta be a lot more careful at that point. And run really far away from the beast when he start jumping like that, because he can get you really solid. So this is not a very good run, but we're still gonna be getting around a little bit over 1.4 million. So it's actually not a bad first run here. Not a bad first run at all. I usually get a lot worse than that on the first run. And obviously, my personal best is around 1.7 million, but usually it's between 1.4 and 1.6 million, which is actually pretty decent considering that we don't have a rage hunter. So pretty much that's all you player guys. You want to avoid missing your proc. You want to avoid getting hit by the beast so you don't get snare. And that is pretty much it. So you do your rotation, 5, cancel 3, cancel 4, proc on 4, then use the first skill, make sure you don't get hit by the beast, make sure you don't get hit by meteor too much, try to get that meteor buff as high as possible, to keep that meteor buff as high as possible, and that's all you gotta do with this skill. Very, very easy to control, just the RNG is RNG, man. There's nothing you can actually do about that. You just rerun, rerun, and rerun until you get the run you actually want. So guys, that's pretty much it for this Alliance Battle Extreme guide. Well, updated guide, because my old one was actually terrible, in my opinion. That was the day she was released, so I was really not up to par with what she could do. So this one is a lot better. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this Alliance Battle Extreme guide. Don't forget to leave to press the sub, guys, if you enjoy the content. For more, make sure to like this video if you enjoy the content. I said just enjoy the content. I should shut the hell up, right? And guys, don't forget to hit the bell so you get notified when we post a new video or go live with the live stream. And on that, guys, I will see you next time.